So yeah, Sonic Mario is a matchup that, at least in theory, I feel like is going to be hard for Mario, because how does he chase a Sonic who kind of just wants to run away? Like, yeah. So Sonic has about as much range as Mario, a bit more. Worse frame data, but the mobility is just so bad for Mario. But I guess Mario does have big combos, big kill power, and if he reads the movement, he can easily just kind of swipe away where Sonic's going to be and kill him, or get a lot of damage, just wall him out. We'll see. Also worth noting is that 6WX uses the worst color of Sonic. Like, Sonic's colors are bad. We know that. But he actually picks the worst color of Sonic. It's like, it's supposed to be like Black Sonic, I think, but it ends up just being like dried out bluish gray Sonic with a black like ring. So yeah, I think it's ugly Sonic color. Oh, and then they have like random yellow shoe, like random yellow on these shoes, kind of, and just starting off. Ooh, Bates to jump in. Side B, yep. Ooh, he's banned jumping. So that's twice that 60 bucks has gotten a really good answer for the jump-ins. Like, not much damage, but just the fact that he's not getting caught by jump-ins at distance, it's going to be hard for Ally to deal with. Landing is red. Oh, wow, I'm surprised he didn't die. Ally goes for something overcommittal, gets punished for it. Ooh, for an interesting setup. Yep, see. Rid movement, back air, quick stock. Ooh, 6BX goes for something aggressive. And now 6BX feels like he has to go in because he's behind. No, flood, push him back. Fireball, move forward and control space. Spin dash just to get back mid stage. I looked away for a second, what happened? Oh. 6 just misses his follow up. Hey guys, do me a favor, when you're making tags, if you expect your matches to be like on stream or whatever, you expect your name to be said a lot, make your tag 2 syllables or less, please. Saying 6WX like constantly is annoying. You know, saying like Komo Rikiri is annoying. Something like Larry though, Zero, Nairo. 2 syllable or less names is easy. And like not annoying to constantly repeat. Air dodge, frame trap. Yep, jump in, punished again. Yep, the classic up B, because he sees that. The thing is interesting here, actually, is that 6 kind of realized that he was going to get up B. Like, look at this. Like, you see him kind of jump a little bit forward, but this up B hitbox is massive. Massive hitbox here, actually. So it kind of pulls him up, actually. Wow, I didn't realize how big the hitbox is. If you're edge guarding Mario, you can't go in front of him, because this up B drags you in. Wow, I didn't realize that. Okay. So edge guard Mario from above, or don't edge guard him at all, basically. Yeah, 6 is looking for a kill. He's kind of fishing right now, because he needs it. But that's why he's just losing the lead super hard. And you see now that Ally is the one running away. Like, he's willing to fight and stuff, but he's not approaching ever. He said, jab, jab. Ally up air dodges there, because he's expecting, like, another rising up air. But that short hop into just falling up air was a good bait. It gave 6WX a free chance to get a grab in the landing lag. Ally fishing for kills, which is smart, you know? He knows he's invincible. So he goes just for a regular dash forward, grab, Actually catches 6 out of his spin dash startup, it looked like. Then goes 50-50. Guesses wrong. I think he goes for the immediate down throw affair. Because that way, even if he guesses wrong, he's not going to be punished. Or if he waited, he could be punished by, like, up air into, like, stuff. So, yeah. Does that. Up smash, you know, just hoping 6-mix air dodges. I think if he dashed back with this up smash, it would have hit. Because he was kind of in this spot where, like, 6 had to fall on top of him. But players tend to go mid-stage. 6-mix especially keeps going mid-stage. Which is, like, you know, what Sonic does. He doesn't want to be cornered. He needs room to dash around, spin dash, bait approaches, etc. Jump in approach, gets bodied. Alice just landing too much on 6VX. Yeah, Alice not waiting for the air dodges. He's kind of just hoping. Oh wow, that was bad. Yeah, 6 fast fell, but he didn't kind of realize the platform was not, like, as far back as he wanted, so he just fast fell and died. Definitely poor play by 6VX there. Once he lost the first stock, he just fell apart. And he really only lost the first stock. Well, how did he lose it again? He got caught by... What was he got caught by? I'm trying to remember how he... Oh, back air, yeah. He tried spin dashing and retreating, I think. And he just got back aired for it. Basically, his engagements for his ally aren't good. Because he's getting these hits, but he's not, like, getting the follow-ups well enough. And he's getting punished for missing follow-ups. He's not getting much damage in neutral. And overall, it's just that... Ally's kind of waiting for openings to be given to him for hits. So I think if Ally... No, I think it's 6BX. Got better follow-ups. He did safer follow-ups, so if he missed, he wouldn't be punished hard. And really converted more on chances in neutral to punish Ally. Ally would struggle. I think Ally just needs to not... He needs to just... Ally is getting punished almost every time for jumping in. So I think Ally should stop trying to jump in. I think he should actually stay with his game plan and giving Sonic room and just, like, kind of reacting to Sonic's spin dash and punishing him when he's landing or whatever. And going for those random grounded approaches when he sees the opening. Duck Hunt. Oh no. No. I already know what's gonna happen. Okay, guys, I'm gonna just lay back. Cause this is gonna be a long game. I'll jump again. 6x weights. Spin dash, escape, use platform. Reza dash around, grabs him. Only 17 damage and gets punished. Wow. Yeah, Ally gets punished for down throw up B because of how low percent Sonic was. Oh, platform escape again. You just see 6x uses a platform to escape every time. Even here, Ally gets 11 damage, but he's making hard reads right now. Ally committed to jump in, getting body for it. Yeah, Ally doing air dodging to punish, but. 6BX kind of realizes this, run away. I don't know why 6BX runs and shields here. Like, if he just keeps spin dashing at the spacing he's been at, Ally's gonna keep running into it with bad aerials, or commit to, like, approaches. And think if 6BX just keeps kind of, like, waiting about a roll and a half distance away, that Ally's not gonna get in. I think it's because 6BX wants more stage control so he can dash back. Like, that might have just been a simple dash forward shield to dash back setup. But Ally kind of calls it out because he just runs forward. Yep, once again, Ally air dodges, trying to bait something out from Sonic. 6BX is not committing to it, though. I don't know, Benup, but I don't mind fighting campy timeout Sonic, so if anything, we go time. Actually, hold on, Benup. I have timed out 6BX before in tournaments. Or I've got like 10 seconds to it and he just kind of gave me a kill because he was like fishing. So yeah. Oh, you're right, Wiener Schnitzels. Actually, you forgot to change that, yeah. My YouTube's just to Buzz now, not to Buzz 18. Fix that later. Thank you. Alice fishing, yeah. The thing is, when you're fighting a Sonic who's just doing this, like, you have to call him out when he's gonna spin dash. Like, I used to say you don't do anything, you know, just let Sonic spin dash and corner himself. But the problem is, you run up shield, he just spin dashes past you. And using these platforms, it's hard to get hard punishes on him. Meanwhile, Sonic has all the mix-ups. So, you have to know in the shield, and you have to know when to call out the spin dash with an aggressive option. Which is what Ally is trying to do. And it's working to an extent. It's just that the stage has let 6PX escape a lot of situations he shouldn't be able to for free. That's smart. Ally did a retreating aerial there. Because he wants to jump in still, but he realizes aggressive jump-ins aren't working. Yeah, see, like, Ally at any of these points could have called out the spin dash shield and grabbed. But at this percentage, he doesn't want to. He'll die from a spin dash in air. Damn it, Taboo. If I want to do Buzz Kappa, I need a good Buzz Kappa. Not just, like, Kappa with Rose's hair. Yep, Ally's giving him a lot of space now, because he's trying to stalemate the match, because he knows he's dead if he gets hit. Yep, see, he gets a call out, because 6 was at the edge, and so if 6 did spin that shield, which he was going to do, Ally gets a hit. So that's smart, he goes for call out once Sonic was cornered. Once he didn't have all the space to do, like, spin dash retreat, spin dash retreat, with spin dash retreat. Nice. And see, he's going for the same call-out as before at the ledge. The thing is, he's not going to kill 6 doing this. I think he expected the back air to kill. Went for a read, doesn't get it. That's funny, that the tree is letting both characters basically land for free. Like, how do you land versus when there's just a tree there? I think, why did I walk there? That was weird. I mean, I get why I walked, but it looks like he did walk into grab. Maybe he was trying to snipe Sonic out of the spin dash? But see, spin dash in there. Simple kill. Out there. And now 6PX has no reason to approach. He just has to wait for Ally to approach. Because look how he just stands there. Sees the run-up shield, just spin dashes out of there. Oh, bodied. And see, this is exactly what Ally is looking for, I guess. Obviously, he got kind of lucky with that, like the back air into air dodge and get punished, but... Like, since 6 is getting grabbed a lot near a corner, he just lets go spin dash. He thinks he has a hit. And he could have upbeat out of the situation, but since he fast fell, he'd have time to upbeat. So that fast fall is kind of iffy, but you know, baiting this out and just punishing the landing from the spin dash is super good. Since 6PX thought he had a hit. He might have like hit the shield and kind of had like a controller rumble and be like, oh, hit shield, but controller's rumbling, so I must hit him. Boom. So that was kind of bad by 6PX, but good by Ally. Mainly that Ally capitalized when he saw the fast fail. Or fast fall. Nice. Nice. Look at all this damage now. Now Ally's just trying to get something, because he sees the timer, probably, but... Oh, nice. Ooh, what Six is doing is Six is realizing he was going to grab a lot, and he's just punching the grabs by letting go of spin dashes early. Ooh, that dog kind of helped him out. Escape to a platform. Up B. I think that's why we're not seeing Six do a lot of these escape to the trees, because Ally is ready for the escape with his up B. I'm sorry, Ben, no, but I don't have time for that. Yay, that's why Six doesn't go to the trees much. Ooh, Ally's going super hard with the pressure. He's not trying to give Six space to spin dash. Shield poke. Oh, I didn't see it, Gruggles, I'm sorry. I'm not doing lessons, Gruggles, until post-Evo, though, just so you know. These next few days are going to just be, like, me training for Evo, basically. It might have got sent to the wrong, like, folder though on my emails, so I'm sorry about that. Just send me another email of anything. Oh my, Six is about to timeout Ally. This is actually gonna be a timeout. Yo, Cavalant, I know that recent episode of ReZero was something else. I couldn't believe it. Yeah, just that's it. Oh my god. This set. Well, guys. So what does Ally do here? Because you know 60x does. He does it well. But if you're Ally, what do you do? Obviously, you go into a small stage like Battlefield, Dreamland, maybe even... Not Town? Maybe Town. Smashville could work. FD, no. Lilat, maybe. But yeah, no, this is kind of... What does he do? Because if he does Fireballs... Sonic can just kind of spin dash like around the fireballs, like punish the landing maybe, or just not commit to do anything with them. Like fireballs won't do anything against Sonic, except maybe push him to a corner slightly until he sees a predictable fireball and punishes hard. So you can't do fireballs via Ally. Like you can just shield the spin dashes, but the problem is you rely on getting the landing punishes, which isn't always easy. Like you have to be challenging the spin dash at points. Otherwise Sonic players would start like doing like spin dash into grab or like spin dash into just escape constantly, and it's very hard if you're not scaring Sonic, especially if you just shield and he just starts going back to mid stage more. Because if you're not cornering him, then he has a lot more room not only with his spin dash startup but where he goes after it. Taboo, I'm ready for my star, don't worry. So yeah, this is interesting. Yeah, so Battlefield, this is the logical choice. It looks like 6x didn't want to fight there? Ooh, back air. Okay, now Ally's being overly aggro. 30 seconds in, this is going way too fast. Start of the game. It's a jab. So, the jab is 8 damage. I'm not sure if that's worth it for Sonic, though. Like, going for risky jabs there. Throwing out attacks. Nair. That was a good fastball nair. He hasn't done that before. The thing is, Alice should just up air it anyway after he did, like, this. Because you get them, like, rising up air into second one to catch the landing platform stuff, but I think Ally is kind of tunnel visioning 6-sub-X's movement and not like seeing like when he does little mix ups like that. Jump in down air, back air. Okay, now Ally is just playing too impatient a lot of times. Nice, catches the landing. What 6-sub-X is doing though, which I really like, is you see how he's using back airs mid-stage? He's basically telling Ally, if he wants to land, that Ally has to either land aggressively with attacks to challenge back air, or he has to land to a platform or a ledge, because 6 is just constantly holding mid-stage with these back airs, and like shields, and space spin dashes. So definitely, Ally needs to go to the platforms more and take the up air pressure, or go to a ledge, which is, for Sonic, another level of annoying pressure. Benmo, probably. I think if 6 plays like this at EVO, he could get top 8 or top 16. Yeah, there's not much else to add. It's really the same thing as first set, where now 6 is not letting himself get cornered. And, like, he's not really approaching. He's waiting for Ally to approach. But 6 is just making sure he's not at the edge of the stage itself. As long as, like, here he's going to attack soon or do something. See? He does an attack. He does a roll in. He does something to keep himself at least a roll from the corner. Even here, he's going to do some sort of aggressive option attack. See? Back to mid-stage. The up air is a bad habit he has. Always does something. He's like hit confirming when he doesn't have hits. Nice. 3 SD. That was really nice. Oh, see here. Now he might be dead. Guess is right. Yeah. Yep. Ally at the corner is super scary. Just because down throw 50-50 with forward air mix ups. Buzz cap idea. What about my beard? With Rose's hair. Oh my god, Taboo, let's not do that. That sounds terrifying. Ipsy! Punishes a landing with back airs. And that's why 6 is going for them a lot. It's very calculated risk taking with the back airs. Top platform is pretty safe. Like, he won't die from getting hit on the top platform. If he went for a mid platform or, like, stage, he could have died. Punches air dodge, but it's not a kill. Smart. I like this by 6WX right here. Like, he looked like he was about to fall onto a platform, but he has air dodge passed. And then he realizes that he has a punish opening. I think if Ally just kind of stood here and like waited or went for back air, that 6 would have went for another air dodge below the platform and kind of go from there. Ooh, up neutral air is right out of that up air string. Up, look like miss input. And now the percent is too high, just DI away and Ally can't kill you with that. Use a forward air, or not forward air, use a jump. I think an up air might kill now. Ooh, Ally went for the DI mix-up, where if you DI the forward throw away from Mario when you expect him to do like a down throw, he kills you. But this percentage, just no DI, will avoid both setups, basically. Yeah, up air will kill, back throw will kill. Pretty much everything Mario has for killing will kill now. The main thing is, I think... Oh, he's dead. Okay. Well, that was good enough. Because if 6 went to a ledge, he was going to be at the mercy of up smash, back throw, back air mix-ups. And, like, he didn't really go to a ledge. He'd rather just try to challenge ally, I guess, and get back to mid-stage and, like, get whatever damage he can while challenging ally. Because he was at 180%. When you're at death percent from, like, your opponent's, like, safe, like, aerial pressure, opponent's, like, grab game pretty much anywhere in the stage, your stock is basically gone. Any damage you get there is super good damage because, like, you're dead from anything. They can just throw attacks out and hit you that way. And as long as the setups are good, they're going to land an attack eventually. I said, there's a timer. Oh man, there's only 2 minutes left. This is so bad. There's no time. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ally almost did the ally. Wow. And this is... Let's just look at how quickly this turned. Reza get up attack. Now, I don't know why 6 DI'd onto a platform as they gave Ally this free combo, but yeah. All that damage off reading one, like... Was that a jump read? I think that was a jump read. No, that was just 6 doing nothing. I think 6 was crouching, so like maybe... I don't know what 6 was doing there. Whatever. Oh, landing on stage, yeah. 6 is super afraid of the ledge. So he's going on stage a lot. Hard reads the roll. Does he get punished? That's hard, though. Mm-hmm. And yeah, now Ally... What Ally is doing is smart. You see, like, 6 is landing. Ally is kind of chasing the landing by going, like, mid-stage, like, here first, and then falling towards the ledge, and basically kind of telling 6 he can't go mid-stage, forcing 6 to the edge. But since 6 isn't going on the ledge itself, Ally is just getting, like, a lot of damage there. And then 6, like, up B, side B, etc. to mid-stage. Since he's, like, going over Ally, Ally's gonna have time to react, because he's not threat of being hit when 6 goes over him, and Ally can just kind of punish him. So that's really smart positioning to, like, corner 6. Neutral, you know. Now Ally is doing a lot of dashbacks. He's trying to bait out the spin dashes. It's not working solely because 6 is waiting for the approaches before he acts. But, like, he's trying to do something else to mix it up. And, yeah. Hey, I'm Mechanic Coke. How are you, dude? Forward threat, smash for a kill. Up air. Back air? Oh, nope, 6 is not willing to take back air risks. He's up in percentage. He has no reason to commit. Ally learned he can't, like, challenge with spin dashes. That's what he has to figure out. Ally needs to figure out a way to challenge spin dashes directly. Because right now he relies on, like, getting these hard reads. Like, when 6 is, like, shielding or not. And when 6, like, lands, they have to spin dashes. And Ally, a lot of times, needs to, like, preempt the spin dash movement pretty hard if he doesn't want to commit to punishing it with, like, a grab. So he needs something to challenge these spin dashes. Nice back air. Yep, see, takes the movement. First time in a while that Six has gone Sage. Once again, Ally. Thank you, Zero Umbra, for subbing. Sub hype, appreciate it, dude. Guys in the chat, spam emotes. I really appreciate it. And if there's a Discord group if you want to join that. And yeah, hope you enjoy your time here. Sub hype? Yeah, see here, Ally jumps and shields. Because he can't challenge Spin Dash, he knows it. Tries chasing the landing, got bead. Oh man, Ally's fishing for every can. Now he's up though. And see, that's he can't challenge that. He goes off stage trying to get something going. I mean, maybe he could back air the Spin Dash in the air, but timing that's hard. Because Six can go above him, below him, like, there's no good option. And look at this positioning in neutral. Ally's trying to call out the Spin Dash, because if Six Spin Dashes Ally when Ally's here at the ledge, what's going to happen is Six Spin Dashes. He does, like, a jump out of it. And since Ally's at the ledge and Six would be jumping towards the ledge, instead of Six having the option where, like, let's pretend Ally's here and Six is at the ledge, Six Spin Dashes. Out of the jump, he has all these platforms as an escape option. But by approaching Ally at the ledge, he loses side platforms to escape to, so he's forced to go to his mid platform, basically, like here. Maybe this platform here, but it's kind of slow, or to a ledge. But regardless, Spin Dashing aggressively against an Ally standing here is a lot worse. And Six has shown he's not one to do like Spin Dash mix-up, such as Spin Dash into cancel a grab or whatever. So I don't think Ally is looking for that at all until he's at kill percents. Ooh, they just catch. Just does aggress. That was actually a very aggro Spin Dash. I think he saw the flood startup. Yeah, that's probably what it was. Oh, maybe he was trying to catch Ally landing. Oh, I think it was catching Ally landing here. Yeah. So right here. No, it was just, yeah, catching Spin Dash. I mean, flood startup. Yep, Ally's trying to force it. Once again, he can't do anything. Because his platform here is a free safety zone. An Ally. And now, if Ally's standing there, Six isn't going to approach. That was it. That had to have been it. Like, catches a Spin Dash charge. Calls out super hard. And this had to be a kill. I wonder, actually. Let me look at their percents. So, one pummel. Okay, guys, we're going to do some very quick math here. Because I think Ally could have won this with another pummel into back throw. So, Mario's pummel does... Does it say how much his pummel does? Oh, no, we saw it did 3. So, pummel does 3 damage. Back throw is 11 damage. It's fresh, so it might even do 11.5/12 damage. So if Ally did a second pummel into back throw, he would have had a 1% lead approximately, maybe even 2. And he had enough time for a second pummel for sure. So yeah, this was a 50-50, down throw, up B, but the percent was too high because of rage and whatnot. I don't think up throw would have killed, not in Sonic. And that's it, yeah. Right here is... Since Ally has no way to challenge Spin Dash that he's found yet, just Spin Dashing through here is safe. Like, there's literally not enough time for Ally to do anything about this Spin Dash. Try as you see down smashing it. And Wes does the pop. I guess maybe a reverse up smash might have worked. Maybe even a well-timed jab. But well-timed jab wouldn't have given the percent lead. That's it, yeah. Zero options for Ally. Oh my god, Ally had that game though with a back throw. A back throw and then if Ally did the back throw, he would have, by the time Six would have gone stage, there would have been about 6 seconds left. Ally's face here looks so derp. This is funny. But yeah, 6 seconds left. Would that have been enough time? Let me think of that. That would have been time for West to get one read in. Like, one chance to approach Ally, go for read. And, yeah. I think what Ally might be able to do, though, is just run off battlefield and then, like, recover below stage. No, because then spring hit. Even if he technically loses. I don't know, Ally could have, at that point, after back throw, went to the top platform and just shielded. And I don't think Six would have had any answer to that if he was, like, shielding and kind of reacting to where Six jumped. Okay. Oh my god, this set is boring. I'll be quite frank, this is a boring set. Oh hey, Genpai. Oh my god. And then Ally goes Cloud. You always wake up late, Jen. Oh my god, he's going Cloud. Ally's going Cloud now. This is going to be so bad. I just have a feeling this is going to be a very destructive game. Mainly because Ally's Cloud is not that great. It's kind of, I feel like Ally's Cloud is what you think of when you think of generic Pocket Cloud. Like, top player using the character makes reads, but makes mistakes like burning that neutral B when there's no good reason to. The news would be, Ben. Okay, so if there's a timeout at the same percentage, it goes into a one-stock, three-minute game. It's interesting. Now, Ally's trying to timeout Six, but Six is chasing landings. Not timeout, but like charge limit, you know, retreat. Nice, yep. Six is waiting for the landing. Gets a platform tech read. Gets a landing read. Oh, misses the kill. Yep. He's gonna chase landing. Yep. Oh, he didn't get the punish, but he had the punish in landing. Forward smash. This is scary, of course, on the ledge. Up air. Whoa, what? I mean, that made sense. Because now Ally can challenge Spin Dash, he's just going to do it. But, ow. Side B's, yep. Oh, thank you without all reason for the resub. Resub hype. Guys in the chat, spam those emotes. Did that outrange Nair? That outrange Nair. Okay, so this game is a lot closer than I was expecting. Let's look at the second stock. So right now you see Ally's positioning himself. He's basically just trying to get openings to charge limit. Like, Six is trying to kind of be in this spacing where he can challenge Ally with just random spin dashes and stuff. If Ally jumps is the main thing, Six is going to go in. He's going to chase a jump with a back air, forward air, spin dash, chase a landing. He's going to do whatever he can the moment Ally goes for some sort of jump retreat. And if Ally starts charging limit on the ground, Six is going to go for a spin dash, almost definitely. You see, he's just chasing landing. Spin dashes when Ally lands because he's at disadvantage. Percent is low, so Ally can throw hitboxes out. Good punish. I don't know why Ally did side B. Just like that, now Ally's losing. Because he catches landing. Because Six is just waiting for him to get off the platform. knowing ally wants to charge limit. Ally's trying to down air to bait six into doing something, and it works. The bait works. The follow-up doesn't work, though. If ally knew, like, I guess, how to deal with platforms, like, that percentage more, he could went for some up air follow-ups instead. Now ally's being aggressive since he has limit. This is when the game changes. Now ally has limit. Now he's going to want to fight six. And to counter that, six is going to not want to fight ally. What? Ally burned his limit there. He didn't have to burn it. He could have just grabbed ledge. Oh no, ally. And now he needs to get a limit, but like if six gets him off stage once, this is really bad. Ooh, I like this. So ally now is being more aggressive with his spacing, like pushing six back. And trying to use that to force six to retreat and get a limit or just to hit six. I like it. So ally is not going to focus on charging limit defensively now. You see it there, dash attack. And six is trying to spin dash, just gets smacked. Oh, that was way too early. That was really bad time. I think ally lost because of that. Yep. And ally had a good read there. Because we already know six doesn't like the ledge. If ally waited about a second more for that, that might have actually caught six. Because six would have otherwise had to have dipped to low with the side B, like waited in the air for it, then up B, and that would have been a punish on ally. So yeah, good read, way too early. And then that was a super good read with the back air, super good spacing. I was actually surprised. I want to look at that again. That was some disgusting spacing, to be honest. He did jump, falling back air. Wow. So yeah, that was a boring set, quite frankly. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it, but it's interesting to see that once Six realized how he was losing being at the corner mainly, he would just not let himself get cornered easily. Ally started at the end adapting by trying to force Six to spin dash in spots where he couldn't retreat and land this safely. And Six kind of adapted by doing nothing. Ally tried doing a lot of aerials to challenge Six, but he couldn't, so he just stopped attacking the spin dashes. Six started focusing more on catching landings and using back airs to, like, force Mario at the edge of the stage so he could just keep doing his thing. And really, Six was very content to just play neutral by doing nothing. But there's a lot of times where ally almost won or made the comeback off one simple grab read into, like, big follow, big damage. Really, when Six was put in a bad spot, ally made these pretty hard committing options, knowing that Sonic doesn't really have the position to punish him, because Sonic's range isn't that great, his frame data isn't great. And, like, if you kind of don't let Sonic spin dash through you, he kind of has to just light throw attacks out. I'll try it with the Norwegian. I really will. And then finally, when ally went cloud, he went from playing super defensive and destroyed for it to trying to hold the stage, and he could have won if he didn't, like, make a lot of bad little plays. Oh well.